I'm Barb Gordon, and I taught biomedical genetics this week. Thank you for sending your students to camp. I think we all had a good time. The students are going to tell you a little bit about what we did this week as far as the activities we did, and then they're each going to tell you about a genetic disease that they studied very briefly today. Enjoy.
Okay, so one of our activities was an oreo activity where we basically modeled meiosis and mitosis.
We have the sprinkles represent the chromosomes and the oreo cookies represent the cells.
We did gel testing of our DNA this week to see if we were bitter tasting people or if we didn't have bitter taste or got much more bitter taste. So over here there's like a lower bar, and the lower the bar that you were a non-taster. If you have a higher bar like this bar over here, you were bitter tasting.
We also learned about pedigrees, which are essentially just graphs that detail a family's history of certain diseases genetically.
The circles and squares represent male and female, circle female and square male representatively. The dots in them represent that they are carriers of that disease, and the ones that are shaded in represent the ones who are affected by the disease.
We also study heredity, which is the study of the parents passing down certain genes to their offspring. So for a little experiment, we drew a sticks, which would decide which genes we would pass down to our Reebok or these little marshmallow creatures. So for example, there's Reebok right here, Barbecus. He has a green hump, he has a red nose, some red feet, and he has some curly hair and some curly tails. So that is just an example of what you can get from picking which genes to pass down.
We also extracted DNA from strawberries by crushing up the strawberries and putting some solution in it. And then we took out the DNA.
We also tested our own DNA, and we used Gatorade, salt, water, soap, and alcohol.
And after we put all those ingredients together, we came up with our DNA.
These are our two essays. This is Destiny, this is Brandon. And they both were helping us with Dr. Gordon, and they were also sleeping during class. This is Sickle Cell Disease by Ramsey and Arm.
So, some genetic information for sickle cell disease. It is an autosomal recessive trait. It is found in the hemoglobin beta gene. It is also located on the 11th chromosome on the short arm, around 15.4.
So basic facts about sickle cell disease. Sickle cell disease is most commonly found in African Americans having two mutated alleles, meaning that they have the sickle cell. And if you have one mutated allele, you have a sickle cell trait. There's a genetic mutation in the hemoglobin at the top of the red blood cells, which causes the cell to sickle. And so far, the only treatment to sickle cell disease is allogeneic bone marrow transplant.
So basically what would happen is that from the switch from valine to glutamic acid, basically it would cause your hemoglobin to, your deoxygenated hemoglobin to dissolve much slower, which would cause that sickle shape right there. So one fun fact about sickle cell is that it is suggested that it actually protects from malaria. So some studies have suggested that sickle hemoglobin actually gets in the way of plasmodium parasite, which causes malaria.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Brian.
Hello, my name is Aditya Soda,
and today we have researched Huntington's disease.
Huntington's disease is a cerebral disease caused by the third degeneration of the basophilia and cholecystratium. And it basically a hormone or a chemical is created too much in the brain. It causes the ventricles inside that part of the brain to expand, causing degeneration, which then causes like limited moving, restricted moving, can't talk, a rapid change in behavior, and slower eye movements. And right now there's no cure. and it's extremely, it's rare, and there's about 200,000 cases of this in the United States.
Huntington's disease is a autosomal dominant trait, meaning that it is passed equally from both males and females as a dominant trait, meaning you have about a 50% chance of inheriting it. And if your parent has had it, you will, if you receive the trait, it will show you cannot be a carrier. It is located on the short arm of chromosome 4 at approximately position 16.3. And this is just a patient who has been diagnosed with Huntington's disease.
Okay, so our presentation is about cystic fibrosis by the Nikitana and Kushida. So cystic fibrosis is caused by mutations in our CFTR gene. And this gives instructions for making a channel that helps transport particles that are negatively charged. The mutations that are located in a gene, they're located on the long arm of chromosome 7, which is one of the 23 pairs of chromosomes that often gets from their parents.
Okay, so cystic fibrosis is basically a condition that's inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern. It means that both copies of the gene in each cell contain mutations. And the parents of a patient diagnosed with the disease carry one copy of a gene mutation. Despite carrying the gene, they typically do not show symptoms or signs of the disease.
So basic facts about the disease is it's a genetic disease that affects the lungs and the pancreas. Inside the lungs, for people that are or have this disease, a mucus forms in clogged airways, which makes it difficult for them to breathe. It leads to infections, inflammation, and other issues. It's inherited from previous generations, and it is usually a missense mutation that affects two proteins in the pancreas.
So the possible treatments are antibiotics, medication to help make the mucus in your lungs easier to cough up, medication to widen airways and prevent inflammation, and different procedures that basically clear the lungs. And all of the above are possible treatments, but it really depends on your doctor and your prescription.
So there aren't any physical or clinical features for cystic fibrosis, but we include an image of a chloride channel of a person who is affected with this disease.
Okay, so in this image for the normal CFTR channel, the chloride ions are able to move through. But in the mutant CFTR channel, they're not able to move through because of the mucus. And this is a fun fact, but it's actually not really fun. It's pretty depressing. In 2012, 111 individuals died from cystic fibrosis, 54 males and 57 females. Thanks for watching.
Okay. This is what we're doing. Duchenne muscular dystrophy. I'm Jarvin.
DMD is inherited in an X-linked recessive pattern. Males have only one copy of the X chromosome from their mother and only one copy of the Y chromosome from their father.
DMD is caused by mutations of the DMD gene on the X chromosome. The gene regulates the production of a protein called dystrophin that is found in association with the inner side of the membrane of skeletal and cardiac muscle cells.
The DMD gene is located on the X chromosome, so Duchenne muscular dystrophy is an X-linked disease in most X males because they have only one copy of the X chromosome.
Some symptoms are abnormally walking, difficulty standing, muscle weakness, loss of muscle, permanent shortening of muscle. Some complications are trouble walking, trouble using arms, shortening of muscle or tendons in our joints, breathing problems, curved spine, and heart problems.
They have thin feet, thighs, poor balance, weak muscles in the front of their hand. Their belly sticks out due to weak belly muscles. They have a slight back. And their knees may bend back to the tailbone.
Treatment often, therapy and medication, such as steroids, can help control symptoms and improve quality of life.
1 in every 3,000 children are born with this condition. This condition mostly affects boys, and there is 2 common forms of AMD that are caused by a genetically inherited deficiency of the muscle protein dystrophin.
So I'm Savannah Felix.
I'm Joseph Tao, and this is Angelman Syndrome.
So basically, Angelman syndrome is autosomal recessive, meaning that it is uncommon to get, and that this also means that both males and females can get it.
The gene that Angelman syndrome affects is UBE3A, which is located on chromosome 15 on the long arm, in between the 15q11 and 15q13 region. This gene is found maternally imprinted in the brain.
So, some symptoms include delayed development, severe speech impairment, crickets, spine, and other things.
Life expectancy for people with Angelman syndrome is near close to normal, but support is required for their whole entire life.
People with AS are typically very happy and energetic, and they are usually seen smiling and laughing, and they also have short attention spans.
There are many physical characteristics associated with the syndrome due to the condition mainly only affecting the mental abilities. Here are some examples of the physical characteristics that Angelman syndrome produces. In picture A, you have that typically happy, always smiling attitude. In picture C, you have the deep set eyes. In picture D, you can see the curved spine. And in picture E, you can see the widely spread teeth. And in picture F, you can see the prominent jaw.
So for treatment, there's no permanent treatment, but there are temporary methods, which include but are not limited to anti-seizure medication, therapy, and sedatives.
The condition was once named happy puppet syndrome because of their always happy looks and jerky movements. It was then changed to Angelman syndrome after Harry Angelman, who first researched the symptoms in 1965.
So Angelman syndrome affects about 1 in 12,000 to 20,000 people, and there are fewer than 200,000 U.S. cases per year.
Angelman syndrome can be caused by the gene UBE3A not being present or being deleted.
Angelman syndrome can also be inherited through 2 parents being carriers.
And here are our sources.
Thank you for sending us to care.